Hi viewers, my name is Eva Sari and you're watching the Clapperball Show. I have with me here dashing young lady. So sweet, she's looking so beautiful this morning. Enjoy.
Can you help me push the car, please?
Are you drunk?
But
I am dangerous, so before I can run away, what is
your Zynell?
Hello, Eve.
How are you doing?
I'm fine.
It's been a while. Where have you been?
I've been around working. Where have you been?
I've been around. Okay. How has it been so far in the industry with you?
Wow. Well, it hasn't been easy at all. I'm not going to lie. It's been really tough. You know, I started as far back as 2004, yeah, that was when I just finished high school. Okay. And just before I entered uni, I got my first major role when I first auditioned. Mm-hmm. And after that, I had to go to uni. So I was there while in uni. I couldn't really focus, on in the industry. So I decided to just concentrate on my studies and everything. After uni, I worked for a while, about 3 years, and then in 2010, I decided to come back, and give it another shot. But it wasn't easy. It was really tough. There's politics and everything.
Yes.
So, yeah. But I decided to, take my time and not rush. I wasn't too desperate. So I decided that, I can write. I think I can produce, So why not? Why not, put something together? So in 2012, I managed to, source for some funds and decided to produce my own movie. So I came up with a story. It took me about 8 months. Because I'm not a professional writer, I employed a writer who lectures at NAFTI. He helped me, we worked together, came up with a script, and 2013 September we shot. And that is when love comes around.
Hey, you've been in the industry some years now. How many years are we talking about?
About 10 years.
But
it's been on and off.
So you've had some challenges so far, I guess.
Yeah.
Like team roles and stuff like that. What are some of the experiences you've had so far in the industry?
Well, like I said, there are a lot of politics, in this industry.
How were you able to put through it?
Wow. I guess, during uni, I auditioned, at Spiral Productions, a TV series. That is Different Shades of Blue, and then I was lucky to get a role, and after that, because of the many politics, I decided to just stay back and watch and see how things work, yes. And I got called by Salam to do Seduction. I did Single Six, and from there it picked up. Yeah.
Well, if you put everything together, like seeing yourself as a star now, what's the worst part? Like you sit back and like, I wish I wasn't a star.
Okay, I haven't really said that, I wish I wasn't a star. It's just that sometimes the lack of privacy makes it difficult, because you're not able to do certain things that you used to do before. Like, you can't just go to your favorite Wache joints and say, okay, let me buy a Wache. You can't do, you're not free. You have to be, mindful of what you do, how you carry yourself. That's the only thing. And also sometimes when you're out and you meet your fans and you're not properly dressed or you're not in the mood, you're just not in the mood. But you have to be nice, else, they'll tag you as obnoxious or rude or not friendly. And you know how it is. It will spread like wildfire. So you just have to, always act and pretend and smile wherever you go. That's the hard part of it. But apart from that, it's cool. I'm enjoying it.
So you have an experience saying, wow, so because of acting or because I'm a star, this is where I am. You're so proud of yourself.
Yes, I am. Because, especially after I released this movie, I'm getting so many congratulatory messages. People, telling me how well I've done. And it feels good because I know how my team and I worked. It was really challenging. So when I go and people recognize me as the producer of When Love Comes Around or as the lead character and all, they recognize me, it feels really good, Eve. It feels good. I mean, I haven't started, making my money yet, but I feel fulfilled already. And that's a beautiful thing.
You've done a couple of movies in Nigeria.
Yes, I've done, I think one. Yeah, I've done a movie.
In Nigeria or Ghana?
In Nigeria.
Okay. How do you see the director in Nigeria?
Well, one thing I've noticed that Nigerians are, they're very fast in working.
Because they have a bigger industry.
No, they're naturally like very, very, you know, they're not slow like Ghanaians. Ghanaians are a bit laid back. Well, I don't know. I think it's our attitude. Once somebody comes out and makes it, everybody wants to use that person. We do have, we have directors, and we have Leila, we have Shirley, we have Julieta Sante. We have very good directors. All those old, you know, directors, when we're growing up, they're all there and they're directed. It's just that Ghanaian producers don't like to use, we don't like to use our own. Yeah, and I think it's about time we started doing that.
Why do you think it's like that?
I honestly don't know. Maybe it has to do with the market. In order for them to sell, it needs to be directed by a certain director. So they're just trying to play it safe. But I think we need to take risk. You know, you never can tell. You might even sell more if you use a Ghanaian. People might respond to it better. So we just have to, you know, take that risk.
Okay, you know, it looks like most of our stars are picking up the production themselves.
Yes. Honestly, I don't know. I don't know. I really can't tell.
Everyone is having a production house. Yvonne, Juliet Ibrahim, yourself, producing and everything.
I know. You know that the industry, I think from 2011 into 2012, things slowed down a bit. The producers stopped producing. They were doing more TV, like TV series and everything. So it kind of slowed down the movie, you know, industry. So I don't know if maybe that's the reason why actresses decided to, yeah, that's what I'm guessing. But for me, it was three reasons. First of all, it was a creative decision. You know, I wrote a script that I was passionate about and decided to produce it. And then also a business one, to make profits, of course.
Wow, let me push into your future. Do you have anything coming up now? Like,
yes. I'm currently promoting When Love Comes Around. I'm not done yet at all. In fact, I just started. We just finished a premiere and everything. So we're going to do campuses in Ghana. Then we do Nigeria, we do Kenya, we do the UK.
Hey, then we expect a lot of money.
We have to,
you know. Let me know when the money comes in.
And then right after that, I've produced another movie, Love Regardless. Yes, I have. I've produced two so far. So I'm hoping to release the second one, hopefully next month. So I'll start promoting that one as well. So it's just going to be promotion for me this year. And hopefully towards the end of the year, I might produce again.
Wow, that's interesting. Do you have any nominations yet?
Oh, yes. We have 7 nominations for Ghana Movie Awards. Kufuor picked one for Best Supporting Male. And then Eko Edewo, she's Nigerian, she picked for Best African Collaboration Actress. Yeah. And we also have African Magic Viewers Choice Awards. I have 2 nominations for producing. That's for Best Movie Comedy and also for Screenplay for Best Script. Myself and my co-writer, David Amma.
Who directed your movie?
Afeolu Mowe.
Wow, why him?
Okay.
People were saying that, why not Pascal?
That was,
I
like,
know,
I
right?
Know.
Pascal is a good director, he's a good writer. I don't know why he didn't come in with the directing and writing. So why him?
Wow, cool. You know, when I decided to produce, I spoke to him, I told him, he gave me some advice. You know, I just wanted to do this myself. I was so passionate about the project. I wanted somebody that I'll be able to talk to, somebody who is open. I'm not saying Pascal is not open to suggestions or anything. Oh. But
Maybe you can't talk to him like the way you would talk to
Afe. Yeah, I've worked with Afe before. And
okay, he's a good director too.
You know, anybody at all could have done justice to this script. I'm telling you, Pascal, Shirley, Frank, anybody at all. When I spoke to him and, you know, told him, I just like the direction he wanted to take the story, honestly. And also, he's, you know, he's open to suggestions. He's very easygoing, you know, relaxed on set, you know. And I also wanted, because like, I was so passionate about it, I wrote the script about my lines and all. I didn't want, I just wanted somebody I'll be able to, you know. Yes, and all. That is why I decided to go with him. And nothing else, anybody else could have done it. I know. I'm going to work with other directors too. I'm not just going to work with him. Shirley, Pascal, Frank. Yeah, I will. Layla too, and maybe Juliet. I would love to work with all of them.
Okay, viewers, that's Zynell on my show. Keep watching and stay tuned.
I recommend GN Bank for you.
Another bank?
Yes, it is an old bank in a new clothing. Our own First National has taken a new look. It is now GN Bank.
Charlie, tell me more.
First National has acquired a universal banking license that enables it to engage in all banking transactions, domestic and foreign.
Wow, this is good.
First National, now GN Bank, has the most effective domestic money transfer system called Tika Plus. It enables you to deposit and withdraw anywhere in Ghana, so nobody can rob you of your money. With only 50 Ghana pesos, you can also open the Wodachi account and save 50 pesos every day and begin to enjoy interest on your money. For more information on GN Bank, call 030-221-8855. GN Bank, still the people's bank.
It's amazing how in this age and time, people still consider their children to be their pension. You cannot guarantee what your child becomes in future or whether they will live that long. This is why you have to work on getting your own pension, and no one does it better than Penn Trust Limited. Penn Trust is the only pensions trustee with a wide regional and district presence in Ghana. You can do business with us wherever you are in Ghana. We combine discipline and technology to make sure that your second and third tier pension funds are managed objectively and in accordance with your decisions and investment objectives. We act with discipline always. Come to us, relax, and your future will be taken care of. Locate Penn Trust on the 6th floor of Premier Towers, opposite Pension House, near the National Theatre. You may call us on 030-290-1500 or 030-290-0989. Penn Trust, we act with discipline always. Penn Trust is a member of Group Indom.
Welcome back from Hot and Fab. I really enjoyed those pictures. And I know you did. Sexy pictures you have there. Now let's talk about your movie, When Love Comes Around. I saw Jim Ike, I saw a couple of stars in there. I mean, not really known faces. How did you come about all of them? Who gave you the idea?
Okay, when I decided to do When Love Comes Around, I wanted to do an African movie, something that would cut across. So as you can see, we have a Kenyan, Piera McKenna. She is a big star in Kenya. She's a DJ and an actress. And then, of course, we know Jim Ike. Yeah, Jim Ike is also, you know, one of Africa's finest. We have Edred Kufu, our own, and Miki Osebeko, and myself, of course. We also have Prince David Osei. Oh, we have Nash Smith. Confidence played, you know, she cameoed in it. She had like two scenes. She made a special appearance. We have Isopele, Prince David Osei, Nash Smith. Yeah.
How did you come about with Mickey?
Well, he's been stereotyped, you know, with the whole Dada Boats Boga Boga thing, but he fit the role. And I even used his name, Dada Boat. Dada Boat.
Okay, in the movie.
Yeah. You know, he was Dada Boat
Dada
in
Boat.
he had a TV series that I bought. Yeah, so I just kind of brought back that character. So I needed him to play that role. Mm-hmm. He didn't want to because you know how Ghanaians are, they easily stereotype you. So, you know, they always give him such roles. And he wanted to do other things. But I said, you know what, with this film and this role, please just do this for me because I wrote it with you in mind. And you're the only person who can do it. So then, you know, he came on board and I'm glad he did because he nailed his role. He did it so well.
You enjoy having him on set?
I enjoyed. He made me laugh. He was the hardest person to work with because he was always making me laugh. You know, scenes where I had to be serious, this guy would just say something and be on the floor cracking up. But it was fun too.
Do you have a particular director in Ghana you wish that any movie you do, you direct?
No, I don't have. But one thing I know is I'd like to work with all the other directors that I've mentioned. I'd love to, you know, experience working with them. Yeah.
I really enjoyed your movie when I watched it the first time. I'm like, oh my God, this movie must go places. I mean, you were talking about promoting of the movie.
Yeah.
You're talking about Kenya and other countries. Yeah. How are you doing with that?
Well, at the moment, I'm trying to like get sponsorship, you know, from airlines and other companies, you know, to sponsor because everything can come from my pocket, you know. You know, it's very costly to, you know, all that.
I mean,
so,
you want to take All Stars and everything.
So I'm talking to some airlines. Kenya Airways. We have sponsorship from Africa World Airline, you know, for the Nigerian premiere. They flew in some stars from Nigeria and they're going to fly us to Nigeria for the Nigerian premiere. So that is sorted out. So thanks Africa World Airlines, our proud airline sponsor. And we are also talking to Kenya Airways. So let's see how it goes.
What's the best thing you really enjoy in your movie?
Wow, I don't have one particular thing. There's so many funny moments in the movie. So many. The character Didi, she's like the funniest person. You know what she does? After I date and I dump them, she goes, you know, and
take them off.
My leftovers.
And then my leftovers.
And there's this part where when I finally, you know, caught her and I asked her that if she like was dating Kamal, my boyfriend, then she was like, no, I wait for you to break up with them first. How silly. And then there's
she's
this part
to break up with them
first. Yeah, then
she
go. That's very funny. And then there's this part where I finally, you know, find a rich man, you know, with enough prestige to marry. I go to break up with all my other boyfriends. And I remember when I go to break up with George, played by Iso, I see him making out with his secretary. And then after, like, you know, breaking the news to him and everything, and before I leave, I go like, you know what? Squeeze his left nipple. Makes him come quicker.
Are you serious?
Makes him come quicker. Okay, and then the cow scene where I got robbed too. Also another funny scene. Shanghai left, he was speaking Ga and then, you know, he drove off, left me. And then the truck came with those guys speaking Chi with the cow. God, I was so scared sitting on that cow. And it was dirty smelling, but you know, it's all part of the job. But I had to sit on it. You know, it was really fun. Even though it was scary, I enjoyed it a lot.
Yeah.
And so many of them.
So you
know.
See this movie going very far.
I see it going places by God's grace. I'm trying to, you know, I'm doing my best, my possible best. And I know God will, you know, finish it up for me. So, yeah.
And I know it was very tiring. I mean, gathering all these stars on
set. It was, yeah. And that's one thing, one secret. You just have to make your artist comfortable and they'll deliver and give you what you want. So for all my cast, I always, you know, tell them, I couldn't have done this alone. They have been very supportive, you know. It was so tough, but they were understanding, you know, and we worked tirelessly to come up with this. So thanks to all my cast and crew members.
Wow.
Looking for a venue for your wedding reception? conferences and retreats, outside catering, recreation. Look no further than Coconut Grove Beach Resort Hotel, located in Elmina. Coconut Grove Hotels, memories worth repeating.
I recommend GN Bank for you.
Another bank?
Yes, it is an old bank in a new clothing. Our own First National has taken a new look. It is now GN Bank. Charlie, tell me more. First National has acquired a universal banking license that enables it to engage in all banking transactions, domestic and foreign.
Wow, this is good.
First National, now GN Bank, has the most effective domestic money transfer system called Tika Plus. It enables you to deposit and withdraw anywhere in Ghana, so nobody can rob you of your money. With only 50 Ghana pesos, you can also open the Wodachi account and save 50 pesos every day and begin to enjoy interest on your money. For more information on GN Bank, call 030-221-8855. GN Bank, still the people's bank.
It's amazing how in this age and time, people still consider their children to be their pension. You cannot guarantee what your child becomes in future or whether they will live that long. This is why you have to work on getting your own pension, and no one does it better than Penn Trust Limited. Penn Trust is the only pensions trustee with a wide regional and district presence in Ghana. You can do business with us wherever you are in Ghana. We combine discipline and technology to make sure that your second and third tier pension funds are managed objectively and in accordance with your decisions and investment objectives. We act with discipline always. Come to us, relax, and your future will be taken care of. Locate Penn Trust on the 6th floor of Premier Towers, opposite Pension House, near the National Theatre. You may call us on 030-290-1500 or 030-290-0989. Penn Trust, we act with discipline always. Penn Trust is a member of Group Indom.
Have any projects for this 2015?
Well, yeah, definitely. I've just not decided on the script yet because, you know, I just started promoting When Life Comes Around, and it's quite big and I have a lot to do with it. After that, I have to promote the second one, so I'm not really thinking about that yet. Hopefully, like I said, towards the end of the year when I'm done promoting these two movies, then I can settle down. But I'm producing for other people as well, so for now, I can't really tell. I know I'm going to do it again, but I need to be through with this first before I move on to the next one. So let's just keep our fingers crossed. Who knows?
Good luck with that. Good
Thank
luck
you.
With that. So how do you see yourself in the industry for like the next 5 years?
I'm hoping the brand Zynell will grow bigger. Box Pictures will also be bigger. I'm hoping that we'll be able to, you know, shoot some, you know,
for more interesting
projects, you know, and also be able to collaborate with people. For me, I want to do stuff with, I don't want to just do, you know, I don't want to limit myself. Yeah, I want to be able to collaborate with other industries in Africa and even the world, you know, other parts of the world. So that's what I'm really, you know, looking at, looking forward to doing. So let's see how it goes. With God on our side, everything is possible.
Thank you, Zynell. Thank you so much for coming
Thank
on the
Clap for having
show.
Me.
This is all we have for you today. Stay tuned as I bring to you the next edition of the Clapperboard Show. I'm not just leaving you, I'm leaving you with the footage of the new movie from Zynell, When Love Comes Around. Enjoy.
That girl is my best friend. And I don't like the way you talk about her. I mean, her name is Love. L-O-V-E.
Well, with a name like that, someone would think you know something about love.
If this is what marriage does to people, then I am never getting married.
Yours is way sorry ass.
Love? What? Come on!
I cook.
A cook?
Sometimes I wait tables.
He's a waiter. Oh my god, what happened to your standards? You're dating a waiter.
See this girl right here? All she's gonna do is spend your money. And when she's done, she invites her friends too.
I put $20,000 into your account. And you're breaking up with me like this?
My name is Douglas. Otiko Kosuo, Mama.
Nice to meet you, Douglas.
You can call me Doggy.
AKA 2 Chainz.
So, tell me, how rich are you exactly?
I'm in love with the fact that he is super rich.
Whoa!
Seriously? There was no for, no during, no after. There was just no play.
Money isn't everything. You wrecked my marriage and now you're calling me a hater when I'm trying to give you advice?
Correction. I gave you an opportunity to get your life back.
If you call this a life, you're a gold-digging, money-grabbing twat.
Pay me back, huh? Hakim, you'll never find another woman like me.
Amen! Amen!
Fuck you, bastard.
I want you to be my queen.
That's what's up.
Marry me, baby.
Marry me.
Don't play with me.
Dragon breath tip. I wonder if you eat shit for breakfast. I actually came to break up with you, but it looks like you beat me to it.
Take your cat and my toe jacket!
Can you help me push the car, please?
Are you drunk?
I'm dangerous.